This is Dr. Lam from drlam.com talking to you about the issues of miscarriages, especially when it's repeated miscarriages in people who does not have adrenal fatigue syndrome type symptoms. Now, let's take a step back and understand first why people have miscarriages. The conventional medicine approach usually is to make sure that there's no structural problem with the fetus, as well as no hormonal problems with the mother. These are the most frequently causes of miscarriages, especially in the first trimester when the fetus is very, very small. Now, miscarriages can be due to the body shedding unwanted and defective fetus, or it commonly and unfortunately oftentimes misunderstood or passed over as insignificant is that it can be due to insufficient progesterone. Now, progesterone function is a very unique hormone. It is a hormone that is, as the name implies, necessary for progestation, which is the process of keeping the baby in the uterus in a healthy state. Without adequate amount of progesterone, the fetus will not survive. This is just as simple as that. In fact, during the first trimester, progesterone level in the body gradually rises to very, very high level within the first 12 weeks. And if this rise in progesterone is insufficient for whatever reason, then miscarriages will occur. Now, in the case of adrenal fatigue, we know oftentimes there's an accompanying progesterone deficiency or failure to be able to reach a high level of progesterone. And this could be due to many reasons, from a progesterone shunting process in the adrenal glands, as well as simply estrogen dominance, which is very prevalent in adrenal fatigue. The summary, therefore, is that if the progesterone is insufficient, the baby cannot be kept. So even though you may not have signs of adrenal fatigue syndrome typically, such as fatigue, hypoglycemia, insomnia, and low exercise capacity, some people simply have the weakest link in their system as the fertility and reproductive department, in which case the progesterone level will be the most sensitive in terms of being deficient. And while it may not be deficient in normal people, the same level can be deficient in an adrenal fatigue body, even though the symptoms are not quite there in terms of classic adrenal fatigue. To make myself very clear, it is very, very important for you to understand that the presentation, therefore, of adrenal fatigue does not necessarily have to be fatigue in nature. It can be reproductive disruption. It could be other issues such as heart palpitations, insomnia. And it's up to the practitioner and up to you to really fully understand your body and to be able to put all the pieces of the puzzle together. If you don't, then oftentimes you can be misled into thinking that this is a single focus reproductive disruption because of structural problem and repeated miscarriage. It can often be the case. And we have people that have 5, 6, or 7 miscarriages, especially in the first trimester, not knowing what to do and not knowing the reasons. And until you find out the reason, you will not be able to solve the problem. The good news is that this is actually a problem that's relatively easy to fix. And your doctor, once alerted, will be able to embark on a program to make sure that you have enough progesterone to reduce the probability and chances of reproductive disruption in the first trimester. So an easy problem to fix if you are alert, but it can be a devastating problem and frustrating and emotionally draining if you don't have that radar to detect these other possibilities other than structural problems in the case of miscarriages and reproductive disruptions in adrenal fatigue. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.